Today we are going to solve one important problem, preparing trading and profit and loss account. It is an important question that has been asked in the previous year question. Let me read the question first. Amresh and Brothers is a partnership firm. The firm has a branch at Mumbai. As on the year ended 31st December, Mumbai branch manager sent the following branch trial balance for incorporation in the head office book. It means it is a trial balance of branch. If trial balance of branch is given, it is supposed to be an independent branch. So, independent branch trial balance is given. Let me read one by one. 18% term loan. It is a liability of the branch. Goods received from head office at invoice price rupees 12 lakhs. It has to be in the trading account, branch trading account. Opening stock, it is also coming in trading, branch trading account. Salaries and wages, it will be in the profit and loss account. And then branch expenses also will be in the profit and loss account. Fixed asset, it is an asset. Sales, it will be in the credit side of the trading account, branch trading account. Head office balance, credit balance is given 2,46,000. It is a liability of the branch. And then some adjustments are given. I will read one by one. The branch manager is entitled to get commission 10% on net profit before commission. If it is net profit before commission, we have to deduct all expenses except commission from the net profit that we have derived. On that balance, we have to calculate commission. That is 10 by 100. This is a ratio, we have to use this. And then branch account in the head office books is rupees 3,80,000 rupees. 3,80,000 rupees, that means that amount is due by branch to the head office. So it is a opening balance of branch account in the head office book. And then branch manager sent rupees 87,500 which was not received at the head office as on 31st December. Branch manager sent rupees 87,000 rupees. It has sent but it has not been received by the head office. So in head office book, cash in transit account debtor. It is a separate title we have to use here. If amount sent by branch, but it has not been received. At the time, we have to use cash in transit. Cash in transit account data to branch account in the books of head office. And then consignment value rupees 46,500 dispatched from head office did not reach the branch. So, some goods to the value of rupees 46,500 sent by head office, but it was not received by the branch till now. So, as far as branch is concerned, one entry is to be passed, goods in receipt account debtor to head office. And then depreciation on branch fixed assets was chargeable at 10%. So we have to calculate 10%. But as per the trial balance, it is given 2,50,000 rupees on which we have to calculate depreciation 10%. So depreciation will be in the debit side of the profit and loss account. It has to be deducted subsequently in the balance sheet asset side. And then goods were sent to branch at cost plus 20% and sales were made after making 20% profit on invoice price. So if the cost is 100 rupees, the profit margin will be 20% for head office. So 120 rupees, the head office will send the goods to branch. After that, it will send by fixing 10 more percent profit percentage on that price, it will be sold by the branch. So we will calculate while we are solving the problem on the board. Branch did not maintain any head office account. In the trial balance, head office balance is just a balancing figure. You are required to prepare branch account in the head office and then branch profit and loss account. Let me solve on the board now.
Today, let us solve the problem. First of all, we have to find out the profit margin. Point number 5, goods were sent to branch at cost plus 20% and sales were made after making 20% profit on invoice price. So how to calculate the profit margin from head office to branch? Head office, actually if the cost price is 100 rupees, the head office will fix 20% margin. So it will supply the goods to the branch at 120 rupees. 20 rupees is the profit margin. 100 rupees is the cost price. Then what will be the ratio on the basis of cost? On the basis of cost means what? cost is 100 rupees, profit margin 20 rupees. So if you calculate the profit margin on cost, 20 by 100, that is 1/5 of the cost. If any cost is given, if you multiply by 1/5, then the profit margin will be ascertained. And then, if you want to calculate the profit margin on invoice price, how to find out invoice price? The cost is 100 rupees, profit margin 20 rupees, so invoice price 120 rupees, so invoice price 120 rupees, out of that the profit margin 20 rupees, so what will be the ratio? 1 by 6 of invoice price. If invoice price is given, on that basis, if we calculate 1/6 of the invoice price, then the profit margin will be found out. And then, branch to outsales. So far we have seen about up to branch. And then branch to outsales. If from branch, if we sell the commodity to outsiders, how much percentage we have to make? So, invoice price. What we can treat it as invoice price 100%. So, if the invoice price is 100%, the profit margin is 20%, so selling price will be 120 rupees. Cost price will be, and invoice price will be 100 rupees. So, if you want to find out the profit margin on invoice price how much? 100 rupees. The profit margin how much? 20. 20 by 100 equal to 1 by 5th of invoice price. So, it is a ratio to find out the profit margin on invoice price. If you find out the profit margin on selling price, so selling price how much? 20%. And then 100 plus 20, 120, it is a selling price. So if it is selling price 120, the profit margin will be 20. So 20 by 120, that is 1/6 of the selling price. It is important point. By using this method, we have to find out value of closing stock. So that I am explaining. And then note number 2. Calculation of closing stock. Opening stock given as per the trade balance 4,80,000 and then goods sent to branch 12,46,500. I mean 12 lakhs. Apart from that, the goods worth rupees 46,500. That is 46,500. I mean point number 3. A consignment value of 46,500 dispatched from head office did not reach the branch till the year ended. So it was in goods in transit. So we have to add this also. So how much are goods? Goods sent to branch, 12 lakhs. Apart from that, goods sent to branch, but it has not been received by the branch, 46,000. Total we have to add. If you add 12 lakhs, 46,500 rupees. So this amount will be available for sale as far as branch is concerned. Now we have to calculate closing stock, because the closing stock is given, is not given in the adjustment column. And then, so we have to calculate. How we will calculate? If there is an invoice price, if there is a selling price is given, we will calculate 1/6 of the selling price. How much sale is made? Sale according to the trade balance, what is the sale? 16,32,000. This is a sale amount. So, sale amount, the sales minus branch profit. How to calculate branch profit? According to the note 1B, branch to outsiders. How much we have to find out the profit margin? By using 1/6 of the selling price. So, here selling price is given, 16,32,000. So, what will be the branch profit? Sales into, selling price or sales into 1 by 6. So sales into, this is a profit. So 16,32,000 divided by 6, 1 by 6, 2,72,000 rupees. We can arrive 2,72,000 here. If you deduct the 2,72,000 from 16,32,000, the amount will be 30,60,000 rupees. So this is the invoice price of goods sold. It is a sales price including the profit margin. It is an invoice price of goods available for sale. So if we deduct this amount, we can find out how much of stock still not sold. That is a closing stock. So that amount will be 3,66,500 rupees. Now The opening stock is given 480,000. And then in trading account, branch trading account in the books of Mumbai branch. Branch trading account. Goods received from head office. Already we have received. It is in transit. Both we have to add. So 12,46,500 rupees. And then sales figure is given in the trade balance itself. 16,32,000 rupees. And then gross profit we have to calculate. The closing stock as per the note 2. We have calculated 3,66,500 rupees. This is a closing stock. So if we balance, then you can easily arrive the gross profit. That is 2,72,000 rupees. It has to be transferred to the profit and loss account. So this is B body. To gross profit B body 2,72,000. And then other expenses available, other expenses according to trial balance we have to enter one by one. Salaries and wages 1,50,000, expenses 48,000. Provision for depreciation. We have to provide depreciation. How much we have to provide? 10%. 2,50,000 as per trial balance it is given. Fixed assets value. So 10% on 2,50,000, 23,000 rupees. And then interest on loan, 18% interest. How much loan? 2,50,000. So 2,50,000 into 18%, that is 45,000 rupees. It is interest on loan. And then manager's commission. How to find out the manager commission? There is a gross profit. Apart from that, there are so many expenses. Now, from gross profit, understand, from gross profit, we have to deduct all expenses, these expenses, except manager commission, because we have not yet arrived, we have not yet found out. So, gross profit minus salary and wages 1,50,000, minus expenses 48,000, minus provision for depreciation 25,000, minus interest on loan 45,000. If we minus, one balance will be coming. That is the net profit before, this is a net profit before commission. So, we have to calculate that much amount. So, 2,72,000. So 2,72,000 minus 1,50,000 and then 48,000, 25,000, 45,000. The amount will be 4,000 rupees. So 10% on 4,000 rupees. So the manager's commission will be 400 rupees. This is manager commission. If it is given after commission, then there is another formula. 4,000 into 10 by 110. If it is before commission, 4,000 into 10 by 100, normal. So, if we calculate normally, it will be coming around 400 rupees. It is a manager's commission. If we balance now, this is a net profit, 3,600. It has to be transferred to the head office account. Understand? In addition to branch trading and profit and loss account, we have to prepare one branch account in the books of head office. In the books of head office, what is the balance? That is the opening balance given in the question itself. 3,80,000 rupees. This amount is due by the branch. So the opening balance 3,80,000. Apart from that, we have calculated one profit and loss account. In profit and loss account, 3,600 rupees is a net profit of the branch account. It has to be transferred to the head office book. So that amount also to be obtained only with the head office. So these two should be added. So branch account head are to general profit and loss account 3,600, and then apart from that, some cash in transit, some cash amounting to 87,500 sent by branch. So what will be the entry here? Cash in transit account data, cash in transit account data to branch. So cash in transit account data to branch 87,500. Now if we balance, so this much of amount is to be receivable from the branch. Out of that he has sent, 87,500 rupees. The balance still we have to, head office has to obtain from the branch. This is 2,96,100. This amount is due by the branch. We calculated the branch account. And then, as far as branch is concerned, one important statement, that the reconciliation of head office and branch, it is very much needed, because if we calculated in branch books and head office books, what is the amount actually due by the branch? We can check it up and we can prove ourselves whether it is correct or not. So in head office books, you can leave this one, you concentrate this. head office book, the balance in branch account, the same amount, 3,80,000. And then cash in transit, actually balance, debit balance, cash in transit 87,580 credit balance, and then profit transferred from branch 3,600, this is a debit balance. It is nothing but it is an abstract of the branch account in the head office book, it is an abstract. If you calculate, so 2,96,100 rupees, it is correct as far as head office books. What about the branch books? As for the branch books, if you prepare, the same amount will come or not? We have to check it out. So, the balance in head office, this amount is given in the dry balance, it's a 2,46,000. It is a credit balance. Balance in head office, the branch balance in head office is 2,46,000. It is a credit balance. And then, apart from that, the goods have been sent by the head office to branch. It is still in transit. It has not received. Even if it is not received, it has to be credited. So, another credit, 46,500 rupees. Clear. And then net profit we have arrived just 5 minutes before. We have calculated profit and loss account from which we have arrived net profit amounting to 3,600 rupees. That is also credit. So if we add this amount 2,96,100 rupees, still we have to give to branch. So here also 2,96,000. Here also 2,96,100. So our reconciliation is correct. What we have arrived, what we prepared, the statement are correct. And then one important point, some adjustment entries are to be passed both in at the head office books and branch books. In head office books, there are two transactions, cash in transit. Cash rupees 87,500 rupees sent by branch. So in head office books, cash in receipt account data, cash in transit account data to branch, it's correct. And then in branch, we have calculated the net profit, that is 3,600 rupees. It is an income of head office. So it should be credited in head office books. Branch has to be transferred. So branch account data to general profit and loss account. This is also correct. And then in branch books, we have to make two entries because goods received from head office. Because the goods in transit also, they have dispatched some goods to branch. Still, the branch has not received. So, it is in receipt. We have to transfer this goods received from head office account. So, goods received head office account data to head office. This adjustment entries is to be passed. Apart from that, and then head office. While we are preparing head office account, I mean branch account, branch profit and loss account, there is a profit. Profit and loss account data to net profit. It is transferred to head office. So there is the same entry, profit and loss account data to head office account, that is the profit transferred to head office account. So it is a very important sum, please concentrate, there is a chances to be asked in the question itself, and I mean examination itself.